Hello, friends, and welcome to another 3ABN Today in the Kitchen. My name is Idalia Dinsey, and I am pleased to be with you, along with Chef Mark Anthony. Welcome to the program.
Hi, how are we doing? Back for another show.
Wonderful, wonderful. You're one of our favorites, you know. We receive a lot of calls after your program's air.
Those recipes
are very handy.
I've been practicing.
Oh, just a tad bit,
just
right?
Just a little bit, yeah.
What have you been up to?
Touring all over the country still. Yeah, I stay pretty busy touring the country. I've actually done shows in every single state in the country
Praise the Lord.
Including Alaska and Hawaii.
Wow.
And I actually do them for free. So, you know, I never charge the churches for transportation or food cost or anything.
Yes.
And just did my 500th show. Actually, I think I'm about 600 almost events.
Keeping busy.
So, yeah.
What kind of needs do you meet out there? What I know that our viewers have high blood cholesterol, high blood pressure, cholesterol problems. What kind of health problems are we facing today?
Every problem you could possibly imagine.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and the closer we get to the end days, I mean, the more problems we're getting.
That's right.
I mean, here in America, we've got the worst health of any country on the planet. In fact, we have the worst health of anybody, and it just seems to get worse and worse. So, as far as putting health messages out there, there's a lot more demand. People want to know how to get healthy.
Yes.
And it's really simple. Mm-hmm. If you just start eating the way God created us to eat, start eating those simple foods, God does the rest of the work.
Well, you know, one of the favorite dishes here in the U.S. I noticed is the burgers.
Mm-hmm.
Made out of meat and all that high cholesterol contributors, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we're doing burgers today.
And yeah, that is right. We have a burger bonanza today.
This is it.
But this is going to help you because you don't have to worry about your cholesterol levels. You don't have to worry about the greasy meals. These are nice, healthy, vegan recipes that you're going to enjoy. So how about
we're actually doing five.
Five burgers.
My best burgers. I've got a few dozen burger recipes, but these are like the five best burger recipes you could ever have. So,
wonderful.
Yeah, let's take a look at those.
Yes, we're going to prepare for you. This is the menu Chef Mark has for you. And we're starting with some veggie burgers.
Just a regular vegetable burger. Veggie burgers, they're easy and fast. And
wonderful. Yes, and we have some black bean Thai burger.
Yes, black bean Thai burger. We're giving it a little bit of a twist and kind of kicking it up a notch, and that spicy flavor is going to float right through the entire burger.
Great. Looking forward to that. Portobello burgers, as we can see.
A lot of people don't know how to cook the portobello mushrooms, and there's a lot of protein in there, and it's just a great burger
that you can
make out of portobellos.
Mm-hmm. What about this grilled lemon basil tofu? Burgers?
There you go. It's made out of tofu.
Very nice.
Very simple. We're just adding the flavor that we want to give it.
It's very appetizing.
Mm-hmm.
And the Middle Eastern potato chickpea burgers.
That's a tough one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love
chickpeas. Isn't that beautiful?
I'm used to hummus, you know, putting hummus in my sandwich, but I've never tried a garbanzo bean burger.
And what I do is I try to give concepts.
Okay.
All right. I like to give concepts to show, hey, these are different ways that you can actually cook.
Mm-hmm.
And once you get the concept of how to do it, you can pretty much run on your own and say, oh, I can put this spice in there, this flavor, that type of thing.
Yes.
So once you get the concept, you're good to go.
Run with it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, friends, I hope you're ready to receive the recipe for the first one for the vegetable burgers.
Yeah.
So why don't you walk us through that?
Vegetable burgers. We've got 1 cup of garbanzo beans rinsed, 1 cup of fresh cilantro chopped, 1/2 cup of carrots chopped, 1 tablespoon of jerk rub, 1 teaspoon of sea salt, 1/2 teaspoon of red pepper, 1 jalapeno chopped, and then I have 2 pounds of peeled red potatoes just cut into little pieces, and 1/4 cup of red onion, finely diced, and then 1 cup of dried breadcrumbs.
Mm-hmm. And these look like ingredients that we could have in our cupboards.
Yeah, it's a pretty simple items. Maybe the jerk rub is something you might not normally carry, but if you can find some nice jerk seasoning, You'll use it all the time. You'll use it in so many different recipes.
Very good.
So we're going to do some food processing here. And I've got the garbanzo beans right here and the cilantro. And you can just chop up some fresh cilantro and put it in there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like the flakes. The fresh seems to work the best.
Oh, I love the fresh. Yes.
And the carrots. Mm-hmm. Little jalapeno pepper.
Oh, yes, I love jalapenos.
You can use
jalapenos.
Green pepper, red pepper.
But you seeded this one. It doesn't have any seeds in it. Okay. And so then we have the jerk rub, the salt.
Little jerk rub.
Red pepper.
Salt and red pepper.
Yes.
A little salt and red pepper.
Very good.
Just like that. And we're going to hit this food processor here for a minute.
All right.
This is a nice one, though. It's actually pretty quiet. And you can just kind of pulsate it to the consistency that you want.
Okay.
In fact, I think I'm going to grab a spoon there.
Okay.
And we'll get this top off here because I see some bigger pieces around the sides that I just want to get down in there. Because the bigger chunks, sometimes that'll make your whole burger fall apart.
Well, that's true.
Yeah, so we'll give it one more little pulse here. I mean, you can see where it really starts sticking on the side.
Yes.
Good to go.
Okay. Very good. So you don't need any eggs for this burger.
No.
All right. Very good.
Some people kind of wonder, well, how's it going to stick together?
Exactly. So. Very nice.
But.
So this is a new recipe to do with garbanzo beans.
Something like that would never stick together, would it?
I would say not.
But we've got three more ingredients to add.
Okay. Very
good. So I'm going to let you.
Okay.
Why don't you turn that stove on and crank this one on high, and then we're going to get ready to do some mixing here.
Okay, just tell me what to do.
So we're going to add the rest of these three ingredients right to this.
Which order?
Any one of them, yeah.
Oh, okay, very good. Oh, actually, let's get that onion going, the red onion, the breadcrumbs.
Breadcrumbs.
And also we have some potatoes.
Red potatoes. Now, I actually did the skin on these.
Yes, I noticed.
Sometimes I think my recipe says to peel them. Skin on, skin
I
off,
think it's
either
a
way.
Personal preference, right? I like recipes like that.
So, but this one
I
has
like
the skin on it. And the potatoes is actually going to be your binding agent here.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And as you smash these down, it's like mashed potatoes almost.
Wow. So you don't, I noticed that you didn't put like chicken broth or vegetable broth on there. So it just sticks together by itself.
Yep. You've got your flavor in there with the chickpeas and the carrots and everything. And then just like this.
Very nice. Very light, it seems like. I like the colors, the contrast. And I'm sure it's a moist burger. Everybody likes a moist burger.
Yeah, potatoes help a lot.
Yes.
These potatoes hold some good moisture in it. But just like that.
Okay.
And you can tell how it's holding together right now.
I know it.
And look at that. It just holds together well. Now, what you really want to do with this.
Yes.
Is you want to put it in the refrigerator and let it set for 4 hours, 6 hours, overnight, that type of thing.
Okay.
And what happens is the moisture goes into the breadcrumbs and ends up really helping the burger. But I'm going to have you grab a little bit of olive oil here, and we're just going to splash in there.
Okay.
And I'll see if I can try to get one that will hold together here. Bigger one? Want a bigger one?
Big is good.
You can make them as big or as small as you want. And so all you're doing is just pressing it together, just like a burger. So we'll imagine this just came out of the fridge. It'd be nice and chilled.
Okay. And so it'll hold the form even better.
It holds better. Right. Okay. It actually holds better.
Well, thanks for sharing that tip. It is so helpful to know that. Was I supposed to put in more oil? Is that good?
No, that should work.
Very good. And we just let it golden in each side because everything else is cooked, right?
Yep. And I'm going to press out a couple more here.
All right.
And I think I'll put them on that pan for you,
Oh, to bake it?
Yeah, and that way we'll have some more.
All right.
Yeah, you could actually do these in the oven.
Okay.
But you want to make sure that you give that pan a little bit of a spray so it doesn't stick.
Very good. So this burger is, once again, we're making the vegetable burger, and we have the garbanzo beans and the potatoes that are the binding agent.
That's the binding agent. Yeah.
Okay. Very
People
good.
Would have never thought
I'm
of
learning,
this.
Right? Yeah. I'm learning. Easily, and slowly but surely. Very good. Okay. So should I let this simmer some more or how
long? It would actually go for a little while.
Okay.
If you want, you can take a look at our finished product right over here.
Oh, yeah. That looks really nice.
That one, I've got a nice little crispy kind of addition to it.
Yes.
I got some potatoes on there.
Mm-hmm.
But you can really give it a good browning action. I like the browning action. It gives it a nice, better type of consistency to it.
very good to take on a picnic, or it's just, you know, you don't have to go to the park to have a picnic. Just make a special luncheon at home or at church.
You can try flipping that. What I do for my dad is I'll make things like this and have it just like that. Just about half cooked.
Okay.
And I'll do that on both sides.
All right.
So then my dad can freeze them, and then he can just pull them off and finish them off. And
very
he'll pull them out
idea.
Of the freezer and put them in the refrigerator.
Okay.
And then when he wants it the next day, it's already thawed out. It's finishes it off.
Well, thank you for the tip. We as parents can use those tips because getting lunches ready for the kids for school also
takes time. That was too easy, wasn't it?
It's very easy.
Yeah.
And there's no excuse for us not to try this simple, healthy option that we have.
We should take a look at the ingredients for that next recipe.
Oh, yes. This next recipe for you is the black bean Thai burger. What do we need for that?
This one, I've got one 16-ounce can of the refried black beans, one half of a green bell pepper chopped, one half of an onion chopped, one half cup of breadcrumbs, three cloves of garlic chopped, and then I've got three egg replacements of some ground flaxseed and water. I'll show you how to do that. Three tablespoons of Thai chili sauce, one half tablespoon of chili powder, one half tablespoon of cumin. And that's all there is to it.
Very good. These are the ingredients for the black bean Thai burger.
Yeah.
And I've never had one before, and I am anxious to learn.
Well, you know, a lot of people have had black bean burgers.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But they've never had black bean Thai burgers.
Right.
And they've actually never done a black bean burger, even the way I do a black bean burger.
Everybody's got their favorite way, favorite recipes. But you know what? You've been gifted. Whatever inventions you make in your kitchen, it tastes wonderfully. Tell us, what is this?
Have you done the ground flaxseed and water?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so
egg replacer, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So we're going to take our ground flaxseed and water. This is your substitute for eggs.
Yes, omega-3, big time.
So just like that, we'll add a little more water to this.
Okay.
I'm going to do this first so we can come back and look at it. But you can kind of see it's going to have to take about one more minute. But we'll leave that right there and we can come back to it.
Very good.
I do need to get some stuff chopped up here a little bit more.
Okay. I've got some, so you have the bell peppers.
Yep.
You have the onions.
Green bell peppers, onions, and garlic.
And garlic. Very good. So that's your somewhat of a base. Is that what it is?
Oh, yeah. Green bell peppers, onions, and garlic. Yeah. You can do anything with that, right?
That's right. Can't go wrong with that.
And I'm just going to give this a little pulsating here. Give this a little stir in again. I just don't like those big pieces sometimes. They have a tendency of breaking your burger once in a while. That looks pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's as fine as you prefer the burger. So if people don't have a food processor, if they chop it finely, is that all right?
Sure.
You're gonna ruin the recipe, right?
So. Now we're gonna take this, get some spice in here.
Surgery time.
Right. Well, sometimes this Thai chili is very hot.
Yes.
And you get one little speck on you, and then you end up touching yourself,
your
and
eyes.
It really
yes.
hurts. Right.
Yes, yes.
And you can get a sweet or hot. This one was a hot one.
Okay.
Depending how hot it is as to how spicy you want to make this.
Okay.
But this is where I'm going to add my chili powder and cumin. So I've got some cumin right there. And some chili powder there.
Chili powder, very good.
And we're just gonna mix this in. Sometimes it works better when you mix your powders in with the liquid like this.
Okay.
Because that way you know it's gonna get integrated. So you're not gonna end up with one big pocket.
Exactly.
And one so then we'll get the beans put in here.
Okay, now these are the refried
black beans. Yeah. Have you ever get refried black beans?
I usually make my own. I never had it from the can like
this. Yeah, and it's just easy. You can just get them pre-done. If you want to do your own black beans at home, you can just do that
mash
yourself. Absolutely.
Okay.
But I do things the easy way quite often.
Hey, that's what we need to do with how hectic our schedules are these days.
Yeah.
Now we're introducing the pepper, the garlic, and the
onion.
Red onion mix that we chopped in the food processor. All right.
Yeah, a lot of times at home,
I
have an actual crock pot going with black beans in it all the time.
Very nice.
So I've got a black bean
supply.
But yeah, for a lot of people, they don't do that. So, okay. I'm going to give this a stir.
I noticed that you're not using salt, additional salt on this recipe.
No, this one you really don't need it.
Very low in sodium, I see.
We're going to do some breadcrumbs.
Okay.
But I'm not going to do them all.
So go easy on the
You want to see how
the texture
tight and loose it is. Okay. Look at this now.
Wow.
Let's grab that fork there.
Let's show them, our viewers. This is the flaxseed after you mix it with the water.
See how thick it is?
Yes. So this is your egg replacer.
Mm-hmm. You could actually add a little more water if you needed to.
Okay.
And you can kind of see it where it's sliming. You mm-hmm. see where it's kind of sliming?
Yes, it is. It's like a clear part of the egg, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's what we're going to put in here. That's a binding agent. So that's going to bind it all together.
Yes. Okay. So this is pretty much mix and go, huh?
Mm-hmm. That's it.
Very nice.
That is all the ingredients.
All right.
So I'd say it's probably, 90% black bean?
Yes,
yeah.
I'd say. I love the fact that you put in the garlic in there and the onions, of course. Mm-hmm. I'm a fan of that. And knowing that garlic contributes to help you mm-hmm. with your immune system. You know.
So it's a little sticky, thick, so I'm going to add the rest of this.
Okay. So if it's sticky, just, it's easier to add than to have
right.
to say, you know what, I messed this recipe
exactly.
up.
Exactly.
Okay.
You can always add water to it or something like that. Mm-hmm. Okay, so just like that.
Yes.
And I am going to let you spray my hands.
All right.
We're going to spray my hands here real quick.
Oh, sorry, I missed your hands. No, just kidding.
That's why I wear gloves because, I've got the oil on my hands like this.
Yes.
And that way this doesn't stick. Look at this.
That is
and it just doesn't
fabulous
stick.
Idea. Very
and if you're going to do a batch like this, mm-hmm. you could actually take, and I'm going to put these right here.
Okay.
And decide how big you want your burgers to be.
Okay.
Because a lot of people will make the burgers, mm-hmm. and then they end up saying, oh, well, I've only got a little bit left.
Exactly.
And so you can see right there, I don't have enough for another burger.
That's right.
So what I'll do is I'm just going to pinch here until they're all pretty much equal size.
I love your tips.
Right, and now they're all equal size,
yes.
and you're not wasting a little bit of product.
Any of the mixture, exactly. Mm-hmm.
So just like that.
All right.
And we're going to put these right on the pan here. And you can make them as thick as you want or as small mm-hmm. as you want. And
very nice.
These work really good in the oven.
Okay.
And
so if I wanted to put them on the grill, can I do that?
They just don't work that way.
They don't work. Okay, guys.
You got to put them in a hot oven.
Keep that in mind.
And,
no grilling these.
If your hot oven's working hot, mm-hmm. you can usually turn it over in about 10 minutes and do it for another few minutes on the other side.
Voila!
And that easy. You put them in the oven.
Here
just
we are.
Flip them on both sides.
Healthy black mm-hmm. bean Thai burgers. But you have a finished product over there. Oh, but before
that. Yeah, let me show you this.
Mm-hmm.
This is one that came out of the oven.
Yes.
You can make it thin or thick on these.
Okay.
And if you look, you can kind of see the texture on this.
Mm. Yeah. Very nice and soft. They're moist.
See that? You can
yes.
try it.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to try it with you.
You'll actually get an idea of what the flavor is.
Mm. Ooh.
It's a little sweet and a little heat.
I love it.
From that Thai that goes in with the burger.
I'm not kidding you. I really like this burger.
It actually feels and looks like meat. Take a look at this. I'll break it apart here.
Mm-hmm.
But it actually feels and looks just like meat.
Okay, friends. Check this out.
That? Look at that.
Nice.
People just look at it like, wow.
Very good.
So, and they do fall apart a little bit. Mm-hmm. The thicker ones won't, but you want it. And that's why I did a double
just
burger.
Just play with
on
the
that
recipe
one.
And the mm-hmm. amount. And but I tell you what, that presentation is yeah. gorgeous.
Right.
And it does fit this flavorful burger. I love it.
And the flaxseed and the beans is binding it together.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
Isn't that cool?
This is awesome. Isn't
you
that
guys
good?
Will love this one. You're absolutely gonna love it.
This is amazing. That yeah. finished product looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. And I look forward to preparing that for my family and myself. Well, we do have more delicious and nutritious recipes for you. Right now we're gonna get ready to teach you how to make a portobello burger.
Portobello burgers, they're so easy. It's a portobello mushroom.
Mm-hmm.
And I got 4 large portobello mushroom caps. And then we're gonna do a marinade with 1/4 cup of low sodium soy sauce, 1/4 cup of lemon juice, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, and 3 cloves of garlic minced. Now for the red bell vegenaise sauce, we have 1/2 cup of red bell pepper fire roasted and then minced, 1/4 cup of vegenaise, 1/2 teaspoon of olive oil, 1/8 teaspoon of ground red pepper, and then just a little pinch of sea salt to taste.
Easy. So quick.
Easy.
Very nice. What a good option. I think portobello mushroom help those to make that transition of leaving the burgers itself and just chew on this.
Yep, that easy. These are nice too.
These are beautiful bell peppers.
These are bigger than the ones
I used
before.
These are portobello mushrooms. Yes.
Yeah. These are actually button mushrooms. Did you know that?
Oh, no.
Button mushrooms, when they grow bigger, they end up calling them portobellos. Ooh. It's the exact same mushroom. Yeah.
Wow.
But they just get to charge twice as much for it.
I know it.
Yeah.
I know it. So. But you know what? It's worth the investment in these because they do give the dish a very peculiar taste. Mm-hmm. So I really like the portobello mushrooms. Mm-hmm.
And you can pop these stems off or you can leave them, either way.
Okay.
I've done them both ways.
All right.
And sometimes I leave those in there and then I pop them off and eat them.
It tastes good.
I like those. So.
It's not bad for you.
All right. Mm-hmm. So we've got to mix some sauces together
here. Yes, I noticed that. To marinade. Mm-hmm.
Now we could mix it in a bowl.
Okay.
But I'm going to do it the easy way.
Okay. Okay.
All you got to do
interesting
is take and use a bag.
Okay, there goes the low sodium soy sauce, then the lemon juice, olive oil, and the 3 garlic cloves minced.
Yeah, and I actually got a lot of garlic here because I like a lot of garlic.
Great. Yes.
So
wonderful.
Just like that.
All right.
And that's it.
Simple as that. No dishes to wash. No extra dishes, I should say. So we are ready to marinate these.
You can put these in there.
Mushrooms. Okay.
Just like that.
It's wonderful. Makes cooking fun when you use odd things.
Yeah. And just seal it up and look at that. We're just going to leave these in here like this.
Okay.
And you can actually just kind of, in the fridge, you can just bounce them around a couple times, you know, and that's all you do.
So how long do we let it marinate for?
You can do a couple hours, you can do overnight. I'm kind of an overnight guy. Hopefully, you know, I do this the night before I'm actually going to go cook them.
Okay.
And so you can see, oh, look at that garlic in there.
Oh, I see that.
Best thing to do is kind of keep them gill side like this and the sauce will actually get inside there. And, but I just kind of bounce them around a couple times and then just put them back in the fridge like that.
Okay.
So, there we go.
That's it.
That's it.
And then what?
I don't know. I got that far. You can probably eat them just like that.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure. Yeah. Why not? I mean, we have raw mushrooms in our salads, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Very good. You know, it's flavorful. So.
No, actually, what I would do, just imagine this was in the fridge overnight. Yeah. You can actually just pull these out and put them right here. Mm-hmm. And I'm just going to lay them gill side up.
Okay.
And then you can just put this sauce right inside there, just like that.
It smells so good.
And that's the way you're going to cook them in the oven, and you do about 10 minutes on one side and then 10 minutes on the
other. How hot should I have the oven?
I'm usually hitting 350.
350?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, so we're going to serve these delicious portobello burgers that have been marinated and baked for how long?
You can do 10, 15 minutes on each side.
Okay, very good.
It won't take too long.
All right. Now
but
we're
I am
going
to make a sauce.
A sauce.
We got this some vegenaise.
Red bell vegenaise sauce.
So we got some vegenaise. This is the fire roasted red bell pepper. And I just got the store bought, but you can always take a red bell pepper and fire roast it yourself if you want.
Yes, we have the olive oil.
A little bit of olive oil.
The red ground red pepper. And a
careful with this though, so it's not too hot.
Okay.
In fact, I'm just going to put in
the cayenne pepper.
I'm going to put in just about half of that.
Okay.
Just because I know some people.
Don't touch your eyeball now.
And then we'll put in a little bit of salt.
Okay, salt to taste, right?
And I'll put about half of that in there too.
Okay.
So.
Very good. Very nice. Well, Mark Anthony. This is really good. The vegenaise now is, I'm assuming it's soy-based, and so you don't have to, this is an option that we all have, rather than using the regular commercial, you know, mayonnaise that's out there. So it's a very good option for us to bring to our tables. That looks really nice.
Yeah, just a soy product.
Yes, very good. Another sauce. I mean, I think I would use that sauce even for vegetable dip, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So we've already baked the mushrooms and the texture, how it's supposed to come out?
It depends. Like, mm-hmm. Now these have been out there for a little while. We've had them actually cooked and resting, so sometimes you can put a couple of them on a burger,
okay,
that type of thing. But you can see how the moisture.
Well, you know, I told you that I love portobello mushrooms, so I want to taste this.
Oh, grab a knife, grab a fork.
I'm ready. Let's see here. So far, so good. Beautiful. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
Nice. Very good. Let's see here. Ta-da.
I'll take that piece. Oh, yeah.
Love it. Love the garlic and love the...
Great flavor.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's
my
meaty.
Salivary glands are working.
It's meaty.
Very nice. Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I want to taste it with the sauce that you made.
But still a little zesty, a little garlicky.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I love it.
Now, the same concept you can do with a lot of different ways, because you could actually turn and put whatever you want in that marinade. You can do different sauces. You can do sweet. You can do bitter. You can do salty. Mm-hmm. You can do sharp. There's a lot of different concepts
that you can do. Or you can just do this one.
So, yeah, just try it at home. Use the bag concept. You can just throw it in there. And the bags work good in the fridge. You can just put one thing or another in there and then, you know, just pour your marinade right over the top before you cook them. And you'll find a lot of good applications for that.
I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. I just got to take another bite of this. This is amazing.
We're going to take a 5-minute break and have lunch here, okay? Let me see how that works.
Excellent. Excellent, excellent. I like how the flavors just all blend together. Mm-hmm. Oh, my goodness.
With the red pepper, yeah. Really
yes.
Makes
well,
it.
I'll see you later. You can finish the show.
Okay. We'd like to thank you all for tuning in today, and we'll see you next time.
Exactly. That's what it's all about.
No. We actually have a couple more really good recipes for
just
you.
Just kidding.
So don't go away.
I'll take care of this after the show.
Yeah, but I will show my book.
Yes,
Before you go away. Yeah, take a look at my book. I've got my book here.
Yes, you have got to do that.
This is my newest one, actually.
Beautiful.
Simply incredible.
And that's how they are.
And I actually did this book. Watch this. So when you open it up, mm-hmm. there's a shot of it right there.
Mm.
And it's a $50 book.
Mm-hmm.
It's on the higher side, but it's full color, 400 pages, over 250 recipes,
yes.
Hardcover. Mm-hmm. You know, so you kind of get what you pay for nowadays.
Exactly.
But this is what I did. Check this out. I'm going to open it up here, and it stays open on the kitchen table.
Nice.
I actually did a perfect stitched binding on it,
mm-hmm.
so it will stay open, and so you don't need to put an iron on your book, you know, to keep it to stay open. Right.
Put a pot on there to
keep
it open.
Yeah, that's
right?
What people usually do.
Now.
So. And
very nice.
Just packed with good recipes, good concepts, too.
Yes.
You can actually go through here, and there's a lot of stuff in it about reducing oil, reducing sugar, reducing salts, things like
yes.
that.
Mm-hmm.
Just a whole bunch of information. Then, like granola simplicity,
yes.
It actually shows you how to do concepts of granola.
Yes.
So you can run with the ball on your own.
Yes, and
yeah.
I've used this book, and you know what? It has been a blessing to our family. So I mm-hmm. hope that you get your own copy and keep mm-hmm. enjoying these delicious, wonderful recipes. Nowadays, mm-hmm. if I were to go and find a cookbook, I have to adapt the recipes mm. to make them vegan, but your book here is vegan,
yeah.
so you don't have to go out and get whatever book and have to waste the time of trying to figure out the replacement. So this is all set for you, and I love it.
Yeah.
I love the book. Well, you know, Mark, I don't know.
I know. I want another piece, too.
I'm sorry. But
it's funny, too. Everywhere I've been, I've got this in quite a few bookstores now, but they say it's the best vegan book they've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
So it is getting a lot of... good reviews out there. So this is going to get a lot of good reviews too.
I don't need the bun, the lettuce, nothing. I'll just keep eating it like this.
Absolutely.
What an excellent combination of flavors.
But if you need it, there is a finished product right over here.
Oh yes.
That actually has
get
the bun.
Get a shot of it while it lasts.
Little sauce in the middle. You can serve it with some avocado, that type of thing.
Yes.
Makes a really good.
Good
burger.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I believe that one of the things that we have a hard time, see, I was raised in meat and potatoes, okay? And so the burgers were on the table all the time, and it was very hard to transition because we didn't have know the options. Mm-hmm. We didn't know what to throw together, and these recipes are kind of like throw together, but the result is an excellent
full flavor.
Mouthful of flavor. Anyway, it's wonderful. I think we should go to the next recipe.
All right.
Okay, this recipe is called the Grilled Lemon Basil Tofu Burger.
Mm-hmm. And it's going to take 1 pound of the extra firm tofu is what I used today. Mm-hmm. We're going to press that and slice it into 4 slices. And then I'm going to make a lemon marinade with 1/3 cup of the finely chopped fresh basil, 1/4 cup of fresh lemon juice, 2 cloves of garlic minced, 2 tablespoons of Dijon mustard, 2 tablespoons of honey, 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 2 teaspoons of lemon rind, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1/4 teaspoon of red pepper. For the olive relish, you will need 3/4 cup of finely chopped pitted Kalamata olives, 2 cloves of garlic minced, then 3 tablespoons of vegan sour cream and 3 tablespoons of vegenaise. It's that
very
easy.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very.
I like simple.
I love it too.
Yeah.
Because it's quick and easy and we're eating healthy.
And get the flavor going.
Wholesome food.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. What do we do first?
We got to do that lemon marinade.
All right. And so we need the chopped basil.
Lemon juice and chopped basil.
Right. And the garlic.
So that's your first 2 ingredients. Get that lemon juice and chopped basil going in there.
Hey, I'm going to interrupt you for a second. Can we use dry basil if I don't have fresh?
I have not tried that. I think it would be dry and not really draw the flavor out of it like the fresh does.
All right. Very good. Now the garlic and Dijon mustard.
A little chopped garlic.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I need, a spoon.
There we go.
There you
go. Yes.
Some Dijon mustard.
Mm-hmm. Some honey and olive oil.
And Dijon does work a lot better than the regular.
Okay.
Honey.
Yes. Honey, olive oil.
That's a thick honey.
I see that.
Mm. A little shot of olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
Not a lot.
Lemon rind.
Lemon. Yep. Lemon always works good.
Salt and ground red.
A little
pepper.
Shot of salt.
Mm-hmm.
And then some red pepper.
Yes.
And just not too hot, though. We don't want anybody hurting themselves out there.
Mm-hmm.
Red pepper's hot.
Well, I love red pepper in everything. I have the nickname the Red Pepper Queen, so.
Now it's really watering down. See how it's...
I see that.
You thought it was going to be really thick, right?
I did.
Yeah.
I honestly did.
Yeah.
Very nice.
And so this is just going to sit there.
Mmm. Yes.
And it's a marinade, so you want it to rest. You want it to set.
So how long is a good amount of time to let something like that, marinating sauce set?
My basic concept is minimum couple hours. I like to do it overnight.
Okay.
Day before.
Overnight.
A couple days if you needed to. But.
Wow, very nice. Okay, so now that we have the marinade base done, introduce us to this tofu. Let's say someone's never prepared tofu before. What? I know there are different kinds of tofus out there. There's the silken, and this is not the silken, right?
I'm going to open this tofu up here.
Okay.
This is the extra firm tofu.
Okay.
And you can see how much water is in this, can't you?
I see that, yeah.
Let me pour this in here, and I'm going to show you how much water is in there.
Oh, my. Oh, yeah. Never thought about it. I just ripped the package open. And
so we don't want that in there.
Plus, there's some in the tofu still.
Right. So what I'm doing here is I'm pressing it.
Oh.
You're like, what is this contraption?
Yeah, I was wondering. I'm like, what is that for?
Okay. There's actually food in here, okay? So just to let you know. And I'm going to show you where it's at, all right? This is my own invention, but you can do your own.
Very good.
Underneath, this is my weight, okay?
Yes.
Underneath here, this is my plate. So I got a plate and a weight.
Okay.
And then there's the tofu right there.
Very good.
And see, what I did is I put the plate in there.
Mm-hmm.
And look how much water is below there.
Even
that
after bowl draining all that water.
Was empty. And you have that much water still in the inside the tofu.
Yes.
So that's why what you want to do, I'll take this one instead of the side.
Okay.
You take your tofu, you put it right in there, put a plate on there, and then hit it with a weight on the top. and let it go for a couple hours like that. You can do it in the fridge, that type of thing. Mm-hmm. And what this is going to do is it's going to press down and get all that moisture out of it, because you want to get the moisture out of the tofu mm-hmm. so you can get the marinade to go into the tofu.
Right.
See how that works?
It will absorb the flavor.
We're going to set this aside. Let's pull that pan aside here a little bit.
Okay.
And I feel it heating up on me. And I'm going to need a knife, so let me grab a knife here.
Okay.
And we're going to do a little cutting.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can do this any way you want. If you want thick slices, thin slices, mm-hmm. whatever you feel best at. And I think for us, let's just cut it in half. When you cut it in half, you always get equal parts. And then we'll do another cut here, so you're always getting equal parts. So you could do it thinner, though. If I wanted to do, like, two slices here,
mm-hmm.
you could get, like, six slices, one there, one there.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll just cut it in half. Okay, I'll do that. So we can have different size slices.
There you go.
Just to show you what it does.
Mm-hmm.
So we got three out of that one, and we got two out of that side.
Okay.
So portion control.
Mm-hmm.
You can kind of decide how you want to do portion control.
That's nice. It's good to see that.
And then all we're going to do is just put this right here in the marinade.
So we're putting the tofu to marinade. Yeah. Now, you
should have a little
overnight.
Bigger container.
Do you leave it overnight, or what do you do?
This one I don't put in a bag either, because sometimes those tofus will break up a little bit.
I see.
But if you had a big enough container here,
mm-hmm.
It fits in pretty good, though, just like that.
It'll do it, yep.
And you're just going to let that right overnight, and you're good to go.
Very good.
How's that?
So
good?
Once it's been sitting overnight, it's your choice to bake it or grill it.
Grill it.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just hit a little... olive oil on that.
Olive oil.
Doesn't take a lot.
Okay.
We're going to see how hot it is. You can test this pan just by going like that, and
sizzle.
You can see how hot it is.
Yes. Wow.
So
mm-hmm.
That pan's a little on the hot side.
Okay.
Let me shut that off.
All right.
But
cool off. Well, I have a fan right here. We can cool it off.
If this has been marinating overnight,
wow. Sizzle.
Then you can put it in here.
Yes. Mm-hmm. What a
just
nice
like
option.
That. And then I save this marinade so that we have it for a little on
drizzle.
The top. Right, mm-hmm. right. Because you don't have to worry. Here's the nice part about when you're cooking vegan.
Yes.
You don't have raw chicken in here that's going to get contaminated.
Yes. No,
you don't
salmonella.
Have raw meat that's going to get in your marinade and get contaminated.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually use the marinade even on top of the product after you cook it. So you're getting a double... usage out of your marinades where, you know, meats and fish and chickens and stuff,
or
you would
eggs.
Actually have to throw it away.
The egg, mm-hmm. you know how you people brush the
right.
food with
so we
eggs.
Can crank this up on high again.
Okay.
And then we got to make a sauce, don't we?
On high again.
We have got to make a sauce.
Oh, yeah. This is wonderful. Smelling
and for
good
the sauce, we're going to do this with some Kalamata olives.
Oh, yes. I love
and
those
I've got
olives.
Some
yes, yeah, so we need the chopped, pitted Kalamata olives, the garlic, vegan sour cream, and vegenaise.
Vegenaise and sour cream.
Uh-huh, vegenaise.
Now, your vegenaise and sour cream,
mm-hmm.
they're both vegan,
mm-hmm.
and you can do a lot of different flavors. If you just got these two items,
yes,
you can do a lot of different special things with that,
mm-hmm.
Just adding different things to it. But we're going to add a little bit of garlic to this,
mm-hmm.
and you can do a fine chop or you can do a chunk chop.
Mm-hmm.
And this is pretty good. And then we'll just add this to it.
The Kalamata olives. Mm-hmm.
Just like that. Okay, I'm going to put a little lemon juice in there. Okay, and just like that, we're going to give this a little stir.
Okay. Let's see here.
And that easy.
Should I leave it, let it golden up some more on this tofu?
That's not burger? Too bad. I like to get it nice and brown.
Nice and darker. Let it longer.
You can half cook it and then cook it again later if you want. Or,
okay.
You know, cook it now, well done on both sides.
Can I freeze this or not?
You know, I've never tried freezing this one.
Hasn't lasted long enough to freeze.
Yeah, this is one of those ones I've never tried freezing it. I would think that you could, but Yeah, I wish I could give you the answer for that.
Okay.
Hey, if I don't know the answer, I'm going to be honest with you.
And
you know,
I appreciate
that's just the way
that.
I am. It's like, well, I don't know.
That's right.
A lot of times, you know, we're experimenting in the kitchen. We do one thing, we do another, especially with me being on the road. I mean, I'm on the road sometimes 10 months out of the year.
Wow.
And so if I put something in the freezer, you know, by the time I get back home, I forgot about it, you know.
Yeah, I hear
you. Yeah, but...
I know it. Well, maybe someone will try the recipe and freeze it, and we'll let you know how it works for them.
Oh, I'm real easy to get a hold of. They can always email me.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Anybody that has questions, or if you want to email me some recipes, email me some recipes, okay? And you can go to my website, chefmarkanthony.com, and email me recipes, because we're actually going to do a couple of shows with nothing but your recipes.
Ooh,
so make sure you send me some recipes. I hope they're good, because we're gonna test them first, of course, but we're gonna take those favorite ones and actually use them for a couple cooking shows. So yeah, make sure you do that.
But very nice.
This easy, and I do have some that's done over there if you wanna try it.
Oh, yes, yes.
And what I would do with this is actually, when it's done, just put a little bit of the sauce on top before you serve it, type of thing.
Oh, I see.
And so that way you're getting a little better look.
Nice.
And but if you want to try that, we'll shut
that
off.
Very good. Yeah, I'll shut that off. Woo! Oh, that smells so good. Mm-hmm. Okay,
just like
ladies and gentlemen, I wish you were here to share this moment with me.
Should have a nice zesty light.
Very good.
Yep.
I love the texture. It's not pasty.
Right.
It's not soggy either.
Lemon and basil complement tofu.
Oh,
it's just the way it is.
Amazing. Mm-hmm. It's very good.
And you should get a little kick out of it, too, with that red pepper.
I got to try this with this Kalamata olives.
I'm going to try a bite, too.
Yes. Oh, my goodness.
That is fabulous.
Wonderful.
I mean, it is just fabulous.
Yes, it is. And it's so simple. So simple to make.
It is. And talk about cost effective.
Yes.
You know, I mean, this is one of those most inexpensive items that you could possibly make. So talk about saving your kids, your family, your home, you know, save a lot of money and eating healthier at the same time.
I just know my kids will love that. They love tofu.
Cool. Glad you like it. Glad you like it.
What don't I like? You're a wonderful cook.
I should have been a cook.
Chef.
I should have been a chef. I started out washing dishes, you know, when I was like, I don't know, 12 years old, washing dishes up in South Dakota and up in Mount Rushmore in that area. And 13, I was cooking. 14 years old, me and my two brothers worked the kitchens up there.
Wow.
So I learned old school, you know, at a young age.
Hands on. Hands on.
Yeah. We have got to take a look at that last recipe, though. I've got one more recipe that I want to share with you.
Okay.
And it's a Middle Eastern burger. And for that, you're going to need a half pound of red potatoes, cooked and cooled. I need 3 tablespoons of olive oil, divided, 1 teaspoon of garlic minced, 1 15-ounce can of garbanzo beans, we'll rinse those off, 2 tablespoons of chopped fresh parsley, 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt, 1 tablespoon of lemon zest, 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika, 1/4 teaspoon of the fresh ground red pepper, and then 2 egg replacers. We'll do that flaxseed and water for the egg replacer on this one, too.
Boy, I'm looking forward to this Middle Eastern potato chickpea burger. Long title, but a lot of flavor.
Yeah.
Okay, Chef, take it away.
Middle Eastern, a lot of people think it's going to be spicy, but it's not always that way. I am going to get the ground flaxseed and water going here.
Yes, yes. This is the...
little binding.
Binding agent.
It does help.
Yes.
Of course, we got chickpeas and potatoes, too, so this one will bind together quite well.
I've used the chia seed as well as the ground flax seed.
Oh, ground, like chia seeds.
Yes,
Chia.
Mm-hmm.
There's a commercial like that with the...
Okay, yes, I know.
I've heard about that, but I've never tried it.
Yes, it's excellent. I make my banana breads with it, everything that I need for, actually.
All right, so we need some potatoes here.
All right.
And we're just going to
Now, if I don't have red potatoes, can I just use the regular, whatever, potatoes on sale?
You know, red potatoes work the best.
Oh, okay.
And main reason is because it's stickier.
Okay.
You know, usually when you get the russet potatoes, they just kind of fall apart. You never notice they don't have that stickiness. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So that's why I try to go with the red potatoes when I'm doing anything like this.
All right. I'm so glad I asked because, you know, if I have potatoes.
Okay.
All right.
We need some ingredients. I'm going to get some olive oil.
Yes, you have the potatoes. We need olive oil. We need the garlic. Wonderful garlic.
Lots of garlic. Look how much garlic I'm putting in there.
All right. Yes.
Over-garlicking everything
garbanzo
today.
Garbanzo beans. And the fresh parsley.
Uh-huh. Parsley.
Sea salt.
A little bit of sea salt. Doesn't
lemon
take
zest.
A lot. Mm-hmm. Lemon zest is where you really help with that Middle Eastern flavor.
Now, you need the smoked paprika. If I don't find a smoked paprika, what do I do?
I don't have smoked paprika, so I'm actually using a little plain paprika and then some liquid smoke.
I see.
And just a hair of liquid smoke.
Okay.
And you'll get the same concept there.
And a freshly ground red pepper.
And a little heat.
Yeah,
pop a little heat on there.
Yes, that ground
okay, and then we're just going to give this a little stir here. And because I'm going to put that egg in there too. Okay. All right, you ready for the ground flaxseed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll put that in there.
Here it comes.
Just like that.
It's all in there.
And this should be ready to mix.
Yes.
There we go. And of course, this does take a couple of those little mixing times.
Scrape the sides of your food processor.
Okay. Usually these work pretty good.
There you go.
It's churning pretty good now. Let me see it on the camera. There we go. That's what you're looking for.
Nice.
That's what you're looking for right
there.
Very
good.
Okay. And then we can pull this off and we'll put it right here in a bowl.
All right.
So I can get it out of there.
So
and then we'll
the mixture is rather moist, so tell me how long we need to leave this overnight to set.
Yeah. Now this one's a little bit moist, like you said.
Mm-hmm.
And probably due to the potatoes might have had a little more moisture in it, that type of thing.
All right, so we need to make sure that we drain all the potatoes all the way.
But this will work perfect. Perfect. How's that grill doing?
Oh, it's ready.
Is it hot, hot?
No. Oh, yes, sir,
Let's
it
see
is.
If it's,
do you need me to spray your hands again?
I do. I'll tell you are perfect in the kitchen.
I got my
you
weapon.
You always know.
Put your hands up.
I give. It was my fault.
Is that all enough oil?
It is. Perfect.
Just make sure you keep this away from the hairspray. You don't want to put the oil on.
Absolutely.
Anyhow. All right. So the oil is nice and hot and ready
okay,
for that.
Okay, here we go. It's too hot.
It's too hot.
Yep.
I can smell it.
You can just shut it off.
Yes.
But watch this. We're going to sear this baby.
Sizzle. Oh, yeah. Bam.
Yep.
There. Oh, my goodness. Smells good.
Yep.
Wow. Incredible.
So this is Middle Eastern, not to be confused with Indian.
Mm-hmm.
If you wanted to do an Indian, you could actually add curry to it.
Exactly.
And then you'd get a little more Indian flavor.
Wow.
Middle Eastern does a little bit of curry, but more paprikas and more lemons and more mild type of flavorings is what
Wonderful.
You're going to get out of that. So you can make those any size you want, and those will be good to go. And hot, hot, hot.
Very good.
Is just fine to have that nice hot type of area there.
Yes.
And if we can grab one of those spatulas, I think you got this baby on. You crank it on high now.
Should I put it on again?
And we'll take a look at that. So, but you can see it's actually holding together quite well.
I know it.
Yeah, it's very surprising, but it
just
will.
Let it sit a little bit.
Yep, it will hold together very well.
Okay, very good. So if I don't have garbanzo beans, I know that this is Middle Eastern potato chickpea burger, but suppose I have navy beans. Can I use that in its place, or is that too watery?
I would imagine it would work about the same.
Mm-hmm. Because
you would definitely want to drain it and rinse it and drain it.
Okay, make sure that they're pretty dry before you.
Yeah. And if it is too wet for you, you could always add a little bit of breadcrumbs or something to
it. That's right. That is so true.
Mm-hmm. Right now,
yes.
Would this be gluten-free?
Well, so far it is.
I mean, you've got a gluten-free burger right here.
That's
so if you're a celiac and you need to go gluten-free, there you go. So
yeah.
We've got a gluten-free one for you today. One of these days I'm going to have to do a gluten-free item.
Maybe this is not ready to be flipped yet.
Yeah, it looks like it might take one more minute.
Maybe you can flip it up in the air, you know.
And yeah, it's going to take another
that
minute.
Number.
Hey, I've got some done right there, though, for you.
Oh, yes.
If you want to take a look at them. And
well, I don't know. Would you like to try some along? I'm sorry you're not here to taste, but please do try these recipes at home and let us know.
And let me show you the body on this. See how the body is?
Wow.
I mean, it really does hold together quite well.
It is. Look at this.
So.
Very nice.
You know, and most veggie burgers don't hold together the best, but these hold together pretty good for a burger. Mm-hmm. Are they good?
Yes. They're very good. I like that spice.
Mm-hmm.
I like the lemon. And you know what? The garlic is not dominant in this recipe. Mm-hmm.
A little bit of heat, but not too much.
Mm-hmm. Very
it's
moist.
More savory coming along with the heat. So, but it's
very
that easy.
Good.
You can, for the finished product, you can just put a little bit of lemon zest on it and serve it with some fresh fruit. And,
Mark, I think you need to go out there and share these recipes locally. How do people get a hold of you?
We oh, yeah.
Your contact information because, you know, they have got to have you over. So we're going to have the information, contact information, where you can contact Chef Mark to invite him to your local community, your church, or whatever. Health fair. You do everything, don't you?
Yeah, so,
he preaches, sing. Do you sing?
Sometimes. I try not to. I can't sing a note in a bucket. But
he sings and cooks.
I think they've got an address roll. They could show you how to get a hold of
me. We do have their address roll right now.
If you would like to contact Mark Anthony to find out what recipes he has to offer, you may write to Mark Anthony, Post Office Box 20861, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89112. That's Mark Anthony, Post Office Box 20861, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89112. You may call 702-236-3280. That's 702-236-3280. Or visit his website for cookbooks and cooking supplies. It's chefmarkanthony.com. It's all one word, chefmarkanthony.com. Call or write to him today. He'd love to hear from you.
Hello, I'm Molly Steenson, and we here at 3ABN are thrilled to use the latest technology to reach our ever-increasing world audience. I remember when 3ABN first began broadcasting on satellite television in 1986. We were thrilled then as well to reach thousands of home satellite dish owners across the United States. And before the first program was over, the calls began coming in. It was also exciting to see the Lord opening doors for new television downlink stations that greatly increased our viewership. Then came the wonderful day when we began broadcasting across the ocean to audiences in Europe, South America, and finally to the whole world. And as God made this possible, we added a new radio network and more television channels to our ministry. Today, in addition to making 3ABN, 3ABN Latino, 3ABN Proclaim, and 3ABN Radio available on satellite, you can watch all six of our television channels and listen to 3ABN Radio over the internet. To watch, just visit 3ABN.org and click the Watch Now button to select a television channel. In addition to our English broadcast, you can watch Spanish and Portuguese language programs on 3ABN Latino. For those who enjoy preaching and teaching, we have 3ABN's Proclaim channel, offering 24-hour Christ-centered programming. Children will love watching the Sunbeam channel with programs like Kids Time, Janice's Attic, and Grandma's House. And our brand new Dare to Dream Urban channel offers practical Christ-centered programs emphasizing a healthy lifestyle, drug addiction recovery, marriage enrichment, and much more. And last but not least, millions who speak Russian can now enjoy our 3ABN Russian channel programs, developed and produced by our talented studio workers in Nizhny Novgorod, Russia. Our 3ABN radio network is available from our website as well at 3abnradio.org. Check out all the ways to listen on your computer or listen to us anywhere on your smartphone through our MP3 and 3G mobile phone streams. If you're one of the many precious people who have blessed us with your faithful prayers and financial support, I say thank you. And if you haven't, won't you ask the Lord what He would have you do to support 3ABN's ministry? And if the Holy Spirit impresses you, please send your tax-deductible gifts to 3ABN, Post Office Box 220, West Frankfort, Illinois, 62896. And thank you from the bottom of our hearts for all that you do to further the cause of Christ.
Well, friends, this hour has gone by so fast.
Hasn't it?
We've had a blast in the kitchen. Praise God.
Five different
burger recipes
in less than an hour.
That's right. Why don't you walk us through and let's see what we prepared
for our folks today. Mm-hmm. Yes, the veggie burger for sure. You got to have the veggie burger.
Yum, yum.
And, of course, the black bean Thai burgers. That's always a good one.
Black
bean Thai burgers. Mm-hmm. The portobello mushroom burger.
Yes.
Really good one. Of course, then I did a tofu. I had to do a tofu burger.
Nice.
And then I did a nice gourmet Middle Eastern burger. In fact, all of these are gourmet burgers.
Exactly.
If you want, you can always call 3ABN to get the recipes.
Okay.
Or you can actually just call them and say, I want a DVD.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they still have the 10 DVDs for $20. You can mm-hmm. always get a bunch of DVDs and share them with friends.
That's right.
Because you are not going to want to miss how to cook these so easily.
That is right. You know, when we tell our friends we've decided to adapt a vegan diet, they're like, what do you eat? Just lettuce and tomatoes? So these DVDs are awesome to get to our friends
right.
that are saying, oh, they just don't mm-hmm. know.
And then when they taste the food, they're like, wow.
Exactly.
You really do eat good.
Exactly. Better than mm-hmm. we eat at
yeah.
home, right?
Yeah.
So friends, feel free to contact Chef Mark Anthony. He would be more than happy to visit your church and do something community-wide. I believe this is the time to stand firm, and we do need the support system, and I thank you for being
yeah.
with us again.
Yeah, because when you get healthier physically, you're getting healthier mentally, and then you have a better spiritual connection with God.
Mm-hmm.
It's all connected.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we want people to get physically healthier, because everything else falls into place
in
your entire life.
Amen. Well, folks, don't forget that Mark Anthony has his book,
Simply Incredible.
Simply Incredible, guys. So get your copy. May the Lord bless your efforts, bless your family, and may the food never be lacking on your table. God bless you.